standards. That will be the first word that comes to mind with Roy. His standards are incredibly high.
He was the ultimate midfield player. There was nothing he wasn't good at. You know, the short pass, the long pass.
Keane, how about that for a pass to Ole Gunnar Solskjaer, who took it in his stride wonderfully.
Tackling.
There aren't many that can stop him when he's in the mood.
Running forward, up and down, you know, the leadership qualities. He had everything, Keane. Keane had everything he'd want to be a midfield player.
There's nothing he wouldn't do on a football field, so he expects everybody to do the same.
Phil Neville. Oh, Keane in acres of space. 2-0, Roy Keane.
When I talk about special players, it's not just about special talent. It's having the mental toughness to go and produce it week in and week out in front of those Man United fans, because they are demanding it's Manchester United. You know, they expect you to perform week in and week out, and to have to do that, you know, coming from Forest, this is tough, but he just took that puck to him.
Roy's made tackles, Roy's long busting runs to get in the box, he scored headers, you know, he scored tap-ins, he scored some really good, spectacular goals.
It's Roy Keane, waltzing through!
He likes the pressure of having to be the man, and he very rarely let you down.
And it comes to Roy Keane, and Keane has slipped home the winner, surely!
I think we were 2-0 down, it was 2-2 with about a minute to go, and Mark Hughes just misses it, and Keane comes flying in at the far post, he gets tapping more or less, and goes running over to the crowd. That, for me, just, you know, epitomises what Roy Keane's all about. The last minute, when you need someone to stand up.
On the spot, on the mark, on the money.
Roy Keane, superb. It was a captain's contribution.